Hi everyone, you've got me this week with some advocacy updates. This week we met with the Deputy Premier and Local Government Minister Stephen Miles. I joined our President Mark Jamieson, CEO Greg Hallam and IGR Manager Shane Sutton for the meeting. We meet every quarter as part of our intergovernmental agreement, and key topics included our submission for next month's state budget, financial sustainability for councils and the recent Queensland Audit Office report and the Gundawindi versus Tate RMPC's issue. We again raised the importance of Works for Queensland money being restored to $100 million per year over 4 years. It will be extremely disappointing if the state continues down a path of diminishing this program. It's been a shining example of what can be achieved when both our levels of government work in partnership to boost employment in regional Queensland. In fact, it's almost been mirrored at a federal level through the Local Roads and Community Infrastructure Program. Budget belt tightening that impacts regional Queensland is simply not acceptable to the 65 councils and communities it will impact. On a more positive note, we heard our conflict of interest submission to help remove some unintended outcomes is in progress. So we'll keep moving that forward to try to achieve some sensible changes. And we'll provide a full analysis for members on the state budget when it comes down on 15 June. Meanwhile, we were disappointed the recent federal budget did not do much to improve financial assistance grants funding. We've raised this directly with the Federal Local Government Minister Mark Coulton. If you can make it to ALGA's National General Assembly in Canberra in June, I'll see you there, as we'll be using it to maintain our push for FAGs to be restored to at least 1% of federal tax revenue. That's fundamental to a sustainable future for communities across Queensland. And when we talk with federal and state government ministers, it's really important that we use examples and evidence to help reinforce our advocacy. It's the same for our media messages and campaigns. So you might have seen last weekend's Page One Courier Mail story with the Mayor of Mornington Island, Kyle Yanner, highlighting poor health and social service delivery outcomes. Mayor Yanner went public with his urgent call for help last month. It captured the attention of the media across every medium, and now the Premier has committed to a visit to see for herself. Or you may have seen the public campaign by Mayors Jenny Hill and Andrew Wilcox earlier this year, calling for action to address the market failure in the insurance market that's left thousands of North Queenslanders uninsured as they are unable to pay the exorbitant fees needed to insure their homes and businesses. So the federal government has now committed to establishing a Northern Australia reinsurance pool. The LGAQ swung in behind these mayors and their communities to help spread the message. We know that if we can shine a light on real issues, it helps support our advocacy and ensure those issues are better understood publicly. Finally, congratulations to Flinders Shire Mayor Jane McNamara. Mayor McNamara is a policy executive member, and this week she received a Women in Agriculture Award at the Northern Australia Food Futures Conference.
And another great win for Queensland local government, with LGAQ taking out the National Mumbrella ComsCon Award for Best Government Relations Campaign with last year's battle plan for Queensland local communities. Thank you to our members, mayors and councils for your participation and support.
That's it for this week. Bye for now.